Good evening. How are you? I hope everyone is fine here. It's a little bit cold today. Hello. I'm very glad to have you here, my dear participants. Even though it's a little bit cold, we are happy to have you here and we are going to start. So just let me wait for more people to join us to show you the platform and to connect you on what we are going to do. Okay, so let me open it. Vamos a ver. Let me see. Tenemos un segundito para conectarles, chicos, con la plataforma y poderles mostrar. I want to show you what we are going to do today. Basically, we are going to continue and complete the section number two. Okay, so let me open because it's a little bit slow. Okay. Okay, this is 2.8. So let me share. Okay, this is 2.8 and it says, in this class, you will learn how to use prepositions in order to describe the location of different objects, okay? Prepositions to locate different objects. That's the topic for tonight. And in this chapter, we are going to cover 2.9 prepositions in front of, behind, next, on, to, and under. So you have this video and then basically in the video you learn how to say the position that these keys have regarding to the box. Behind the box, on the box, next to the box, in front of the box, under the box. So you can leave your comments here. And in the 2.10, basically what you have to do is to expand this view, right? And look the numbers, okay? So when you look the numbers, you say the book bag, the CD player, the TV, and so on, okay? So the idea is that you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pictures, okay? 6 pictures, mm-hmm. And you have to write here the preposition. For example, the books bag, the books are, in the book, right? So you have to write here. Tenemos que escribir aquí la respuesta, ¿verdad? So it's important that you previously watch the video in order that you can look for the names of the objects. Es importante que hayan visto previamente el video donde está el vocabulario, ¿verdad? Y los nombres de los objetos para que no tengan problema a la hora de digitar en el 2.10. Okay, then it says, listen and check your answers. If you want to check, you give a double click here and then you can listen, right? También este ejercicio trae un ejercicio de escucha, ¿verdad? Después que ustedes completen acá, pueden dar un clic sobre la ventanita, se les va a expandir y les va a llevar hacia el audio. And then you can listen, right? Pueden escuchar y ahí pueden comprobar la respuesta. You can double check the answer. Okay. Let me see here. 2.11 says, lesson objective. By the end of this practice, you will learn how to share information about the location of other people's objects. So we continue using prepositions. Okay. So in this exercise, basically you have to say, where are Kate's things? If you see here, we are using an apostrophe. So this apostrophe means that we are talking about the ownership or that something belongs to Kate, okay? Son las cosas de Kate, ¿verdad? Este apostrophe significa que le pertenecen a Kate. So the instruction says, listen to the conversation and select the correct answer. So you have to go to this window, to this external window and listen. And for example, the question says, where are Kate's earrings? Under the table, in front of television, on the chair, in the purse. Okay? Purse. Where is Kate's watch? Under the table, in front of television, on the chair, in the purse. Where are Kate's sunglasses? Under the table, in front of television, on the chair, in the purse. So the answers are the same, right? Las respuestas son las mismas, ¿verdad? Solo vamos cambiando. We are going to change the object. Where is Kate's address book? Under the table, in front of television, on the chair, in the purse. Okay, very good. So then I think we finish. We finished section number two. And for tomorrow, we are going to start with the section number three, okay? Yes, it is. So I would like to ask you to please advance section number three, at least to 3.5, okay? Le voy a pedir que escuchen, ¿verdad? Mañana en su tiempecito disponible del 3.0 al 3.5, ¿verdad? Eso es lo que vamos a estar viendo el día de mañana. Basically, how to form negative statements and yes, no questions with B. Esto ya lo hemos estado viendo, pero we are going to continue strengthening this practice. Later on, you have a knowledge check here. Okay, this is a little bit longer, but you can answer. And of course, I can help you tomorrow. And then syllable stress. Syllable stress, this is gonna be tomorrow. So tomorrow we are going to cover until 3.6, if time allows us, okay, until 3.6. Okay, and Thursday, we are going to complete 3.7, until the end of 3. El jueves vamos a cubrir del 3.7 hasta el midterm exam, ¿verdad? Entonces, mañana, por favor, si podemos repasar del 3.0 al 3.6. Okay, do we have questions so far? ¿Tenemos preguntas hasta aquí, chicos? No? Yes? Tell me. ¿Hay alguien que haya entrado a la plataforma y que tenga alguna dificultad o algo en lo que quiera que le pueda apoyar? You can tell me. Me pueden decir, ¿verdad? Y con mucho gusto yo les apoyo. Solo denme un segundo para ubicarme con la presentación que tengo para ustedes. ¿Pudieron acceder los materiales adicionales del Drive? If someone has a problem with the Drive, please let me know. Si alguien tiene problemas con el Drive, pues también me dicen, ¿verdad? Y con mucho gusto yo voy a estar revisando para corregir. Si hay algún enlace dañado, pero pensaría que todos estamos bien. Ok, let me open just the presentation that I have for you today. Ok, just wait. A second for me. This is 7. Okay, so this is prepositions. So let me, okay, before we go to the prepositions, I need to take the first picture of the night. Antes que vayamos a las preposiciones, chicos, could you please open your cameras just to take the first picture of tonight? Vamos a tomar la primera captura de la asistencia de esta noche, chicos. I appreciate that. All of us are having a little bit, we are feeling a little bit cold. So we are having some jackets and some caps. And some of us maybe can use some, can wear some, let's see, I don't know. I don't know, we are going to wear a jacket. Maybe we are going to wear a scarf. Maybe we are going to wear a cup. Okay, excellent, very good. So let me just move here for you to, yes. Okay, perfect. Excellent, thank you very much. I appreciate your help to take the print screen. Okay, let me share the screen of the presentation that I have for you. So let me start saying, what is a preposition? And I would like to ask some support to read what is a preposition. So let me ask maybe to, let's see, Rosenberg. Rosenberg, could you please help me to read what a preposition is? Can you watch it? ¿Lo pueden ver, chicos? Si me ayuda Rosenberg a leer, what is a preposition? La definición, ¿verdad? Lo que está acá en el pink chart, en el cuadrito pink.
Okay. A preposition is a word that goes.
Shows, excuse me, ahí hay un error. Shows, perdón, un error de shows.
Apple.
Excuse me. Okay.
Sería, a preposition is word that shows the relationship between a noun, a pronoun of some other words or element in the rest on the sentence.
Okay.
Some example of preposition are.
Thank you. Now let me ask, thank you, Rosenberg. Now let me ask to Cindy. Cindy, could you please help me to read the blue chart? We cannot hear you, Cindy. No podemos escuchar a Cindy, chicos. Now, yes. Now, yes, Cindy.
With, at, from, into, during, including, and until?
Until.
Until.
Como con una A, ¿verdad? Okay, let me ask, let me see if we have Ana Victoria. Could you please help me with the green one?
Okay, about, like, over, before, between, including, after.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Ana Victoria. Victor Vasquez, could you please help me with the yellow chart?
Except, boot, up, up, around, down, off.
Okay, but, es como una, but, okay, igual con out, out, up. Okay, excellent, very good, thank you. So basically we have said that a preposition is a word that shows relationship between a noun and a pronoun or some other word or elements in the rest of the sentence. And you have read some examples of prepositions, okay? But now we are going to work more with the prepositions of place. So for example, here, we can say the bird is among the cats. So the bird is here, right? The bird is here. The bird is over the box. Look that the bird is over, but it's not touching the surface of the box. The bird is far from the cat, far, lejos, ¿verdad? The bird is near the cat. They are very close, very near. The bird is down the tree. The bird is past the tree or go past the tree, right? So those are prepositions of place. We have here also, the cat is on the box. Look at the difference is that in this case, the cat is touching the surface of the box, okay? The cat is in the box. This is inside the edges of the box. The cat is next to the box or beside. Next to is a synonym of beside. The cat is in front of the box. So look, in front of the box. The cat is behind the box. Okay, so here. The cat is between the boxes. The cat is under the box. The cat is through the box. And now the cats are around the box, okay? So those are prepositions. Let me read again. Among, near, over, far from, down, past, on, in, next to or beside, in front of, behind, between, under, through, around. Okay, now we are going to talk about prepositions of time. And look that on, at, in are not only prepositions of place, but they are also prepositions of time. Estas tres preposiciones tienen un doble rol, ¿verdad? Ustedes las van a ver que son de tiempo, pero también son de lugar. So now we are going to talk about prepositions of time. Esta vez las vamos a usar como de lugar, ¿verdad? Ya dijimos que on es, cuando hablamos de lugar, es en una sobre una superficie. Cuando hablamos de in, es dentro de determinado borde, ¿verdad? O fronteras, edges, ¿verdad? En inglés. Pero ahora lo vamos a usar como preposición de tiempo, ¿verdad? En este caso, on. We say on time, on Monday, on the 25th of December, on Christmas Day, in summer, in 2020, now in 2021, in the morning or in the evening, in a few days, at Christmas, at the end of the month, at the end of the weekend, at 10 o'clock. Okay, now let's see what's the difference or how do we use them when it's a preposition of time and where is a, when it's a preposition of place. For example, we use in general to say in and we talk about a bigger place. Cuando hablamos de generalidades en tiempo o de un lugar más grande, cuando hablamos de lugar, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, cuando hablamos de tiempo decimos centuries in the 19th, the 90s, decades, the 90s, years, 1990, 2000. Then months, May, October, weeks, 5 weeks, season, spring, winter, summer, or fall, for example. Periods of time, the future, holidays, the Easter holiday, the parts of the day, the morning. So when we talk about places, we talk about countries, for example, El Salvador, or cities, San Salvador, or neighborhood, Alta Vista, or enclosed spaces like in a car, okay? In El Salvador, in San Salvador, in Alta Vista, in a car. Okay, we use on to talk about a more specific time or smaller places. For example, when we say a more specific time, we say on, for example, on Easter Day. Vea que ya no es tan vago como Easter holiday, sino que le ponemos day. Ya especificamos un poco más, ¿verdad? On Easter Day, on Monday, on April the 17th, on my birthday, on the weekend, on Sunday morning. Vea que aquí decimos the day, Sunday, plus a part of the day, morning, on Sunday morning. We use on to talk about more specific places. For example, streets, the Golden Street, avenues, the Roosevelt Avenue, dates, April the 17th, we already said, surfaces, the floor, means of transport, on a bus, on the floor, on a bus, or for communications, on the radio. I hear the advertisement of that medicine on the radio, right? I'm traveling, I was traveling on a bus yesterday. I was sitting on the floor, and so on. Okay, we use at for very specific places or for very specific hours or for smallest places. For example, for hours, we can say, we are going to have a meeting at 8 a.m. or at 9 p.m. to talk about a part of the day at midnight. I wake up last night at midnight. At the moment, Mr. Smith is not in his office. at the moment. At Easter, we are going to celebrate with the family. So look, we are talking about very specific moments, momentos específicos, ¿verdad? For addresses, for example, 456 Colonia La Mascota. Or specific locations, the train station, the bus station, the gasoline station. I will wait for you at the bus station. I will wait for you at the gas station. Okay, so it's a very, very specific place. Okay, do we have questions so far? ¿Tenemos preguntas hasta acá? En resumidas cuentas, in es para algo más grande, más general. ¿Verdad? Y se puede usar como preposición de tiempo y como preposición de lugar. More es, ya vamos reduciendo un poco más, ¿verdad? Por eso es un inverted triangle, un triángulo invertido. ¿Ven cómo va de lo general a lo más específico? Ya vamos reduciendo, ¿verdad? Es more specific, es un poco más específico, en a smaller place y un lugar más pequeño. And when we use at, we are very specific. Cuando usamos at para tiempo, ya damos márgenes incluso de horas o de espacios específicos en el día, ¿verdad? Y cuando decimos lugares, ya damos una localidad puntual, ¿verdad? Un lugar específico. Okay, here, I want you to please mute your mics. Vamos a mantener siempre los micrófonos en mute y vamos a repetir, could you please repeat after me, please? On, in, away from, into, down, through. Esta es como una feta, through, through, in front of, behind, along, past, across,
across,
up, out of, to or towards, onto, off, not far from, far from. This is the opposite, right? Estos dos son opuestos entre sí, ¿verdad? Igual que onto y off. Son opposites. Vean que esta preposición, this position has different ways to say it. At, by, beside, next to. Okay? At, by, beside, next to. This specific position, okay? The green, the yellow-green chart regarding the blue chart. Near, across from, or opposite, between, turn right, around the corner, under, over, among, in the middle of, turn left, on the right, above, below, straight ahead, on the left, around, against. Okay, very good. So now is your speaking practice time, okay? So we are going to talk about prepositions at, in, on. In this case, we are going to use them as prepositions of time. So what we are going to do is to discuss the questions below with our partners. For example, what time do you usually get up in the morning? This is the first question. Second question, at what time do you usually go to work or go to school? Number three, what do you usually do on weekday afternoons? Yeah, weekday, día de semana, but afternoons, en la tarde. Do you always eat lunch at noon? What do you usually eat? Do you ever take a nap in the afternoon? Why or why not? Is your birthday in June? If no, when is your birthday? What do you like to do to relax at bedtime? Can you remember what you did on Tuesday afternoon? Do you ever go skiing in winter? Why or why not? What time do you usually go to sleep at night? Okay, do we have new words there? ¿Tenemos palabras nuevas ahí? Que usted me diga, teacher, no sé realmente qué significa eso. Can you help me, please? Or something like that? Or is everything okay? ¿O estamos bien?
Yo.
Adelante.
In the number nine.
Okay, number nine.
Do you even go skiing? Who is skiing?
Esquiar sobre el hielo. Es como, vas a esquiar, siempre vas a esquiar o has ido a, o vas a esquiar en el invierno. Do you ever? O como siempre vas a esquiar en el invierno. ¿Por qué o por qué no?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, excelente. Es como, vas a esquiar, en resumidas cuentas, ¿vas a esquiar en el invierno? ¿Por qué? Sí o por qué no, ¿verdad? Ok, let me send you the... Ok.
Ok, nap.
You receive it? Ok, nap. In this case, do you ever take a nap in the afternoon? ¿Alguna vez tomas una siesta en la tarde? Es como este, ¿verdad? ¿Alguna vez vas a esquiar en invierno? ¿Por qué? ¿O por qué no? Se puede decir también, do you ever? Es como, ¿alguna vez? O has ido, ¿verdad? En este caso, ¿has tomado alguna vez has tomado una siesta en la tarde? ¿Verdad? En la tarde, afternoon, es como después de almuerzo, ¿verdad? ¿Por qué sí o por qué no? Usted puede decir, yes, yes I do. Or and then, why? Ah, because I like to sleep. Or you maybe say, no, I don't. Why not? No, because I have to work or something like that. Okay, do you have questions so far about the discussion? Okay, what I recommend you, what I will do is to divide you in trios and go to the breakout rooms. And since there are 10 questions, I would like that you can ask each other at least one question. And that you try to change, not asking the same questions. Les voy a pedir que como somos tres por grupo, traten de preguntarse por lo menos una, y si pudieran preguntarse dos preguntas cada uno, sería genial. You can change the answers, the questions to every participant. Cada participante puede escoger la pregunta que desee preguntar para que no se repitan, ¿verdad? In order that you can use more prepositions, para que puedan hacer la práctica de más prepositions of time. Do we have questions so far? ¿Tenemos preguntas hasta acá del ejercicio?
Teacher, solo una cuestioncita.
Sí, adelante.
Quisiera tomar una captura de pantalla de la primera imagen donde estaban los tres listados de las prepositions.
Ahorita, un segundo.
Con gusto.
Con gusto. Yo le voy a subir el material, ¿verdad? Pero con gusto ahorita se la muestro. Ahí está. ¿Esa? ¿Será esa?
Mira, esa sí las tomé, pero...
Ok, ¿esta?
No, la que leyeron tres compañeros. La otra.
¿Será esta?
No. Híjole, es de la primera de las prepositions.
Ah, perdón. Sí, la definition. Those are examples. Esos son algunos ejemplos, ¿verdad? Por supuesto, no vamos a verlas todas, sino que nos vamos a enfocar ahorita más en la de play, time and place. And later on,
gracias.
Okay, you're welcome. As you advance in the modules, you will learn more, ¿verdad? A medida que vamos avanzando en el módulo, vamos a ir aprendiendo un poco más y avanzando más, adquiriendo más prepositions. Pero aquí tenemos más ejemplos, ¿verdad? Okay, very good. Let me stop sharing. And let me invite you, excuse me, to the breakout room. So let me, okay, let's create the room and please join. Unámonos, chicos. Let's please accept the invitation. Let's go to the breakout room. If you have questions, please let me know. Si tenemos preguntas, chicos, me lo hacen saber. Okay. Espero que ahora sí estén recibiendo la invitación. José Misael, Angelito, do you have problem joining the group? ¿Tenemos problemas, Angelito y don Misael, para unirse a los grupos? Hello.
What do you usually do on weekday afternoons, ingeniero?
I know. Hola.
Ahora usted pregunte, ingeniero.
Do you always eat lunch? I know.
I always lunch at noon pupusas.
I always eat lunch. Okay.
I always eat lunch.
Excellent. At, y luego decimos la hora, ¿verdad? At 12 or at 1 p.m. Very good. Y luego usted agrega, ¿verdad? I eat pupusas.
I eat pupusas.
Ajá. I eat pupusas. Okay, very good. Do we have questions? ¿Tenemos preguntas en este grupo o todo bien?
No, todo bien.
Ok, sí. Excellent. Perfect. I'll see you in a minute. Los veo en unos minutos, chicos.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Vamos con...
respuesta.
Ah, porque eso es lo que está preguntando.
La primera podría ser una posible respuesta. I usually wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning. Yo usualmente me levanto a las 5 de la mañana.
Excellent, very good. Good answer.
Hola,
teacher. I'm here, teacher. I listen to you. I like it. Yeah, I like it. Okay, very good. Okay, do you have
questions? La segunda sería, at what time do you usually go to work or school? Tendría yo que contestar, I usually go to work at 5 o'clock.
Yes, it's the time you leave. Es el momento en que usted se va a trabajar, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Yes, at five o'clock in the morning.
Okay.
Very good, excellent. Do we have questions? ¿Tienen preguntas? ¿O todo bien por acá? Everything okay?
Ahorita
estamos
empezando.
Okay, don't worry. You continue. This is your practice, okay? I'll call you back in 3 minutes later, okay? See you. Yeah.
Right.
En cámara. Muy bien. Le voy a mandar la imagen. Ya vi cómo.
Hello, is everything okay here?
¿Sí?
¿Todo bien por aquí, chicos?
¿Me no, tengo problema.
¿Puedo ayudarles con algo, chicos?
Es que estamos en el teléfono y al querer ver la imagen nos salimos y ya no de Zoom y ya no podemos.
¿Quieren que se los muestre acá? Solo que como igual yo me voy a salir, pero déjenme ver ahorita.
Ya le tomé una foto, pero tal vez se las puedo, pero puedo compartir la pantalla.
Miren, chicos, ahí está, pero no sé cómo lo podemos.
No, ahorita me voy a capturar. Les voy a compartir pantalla a ellos.
Ok, perfecto. Solo déjenme renombrar a don Edgar, ¿verdad?
Sí, a ti, teacher.
Edgar, le voy a poner su nombre.
Edgar, José Edgardo Pérez Rodríguez.
Sí, para que en la próxima me salga completo su nombre. José Edgardo
Pérez Rodríguez.
Ok. Perfecto. Gracias. A la Thank orden. You. You're welcome. Ok, you can continue working. Pueden continuar trabajando. Si tienen dudas, you can call me, ok? Me pueden llamar.
Ok, thank you.
Ok, okay thank you. Perfect.
Thank you.
Ok.
A ver si tengo fuerza.
¿Qué fue?
Hello. ¿Y tú?
Hola, teacher.
Hi, teacher. ¿Cómo les está yendo, chicos? Do you have questions?
Bien, bien, bien. Estamos practicando. Okay. Estamos practicando la 7.
7. What do you like to do to relax at bedtime? Very good.
Maybe estaría bueno. Uh-huh. Teacher, sorry. Estaría bueno si contestamos I like it in my bed.
I es like pregunta directa, ¿verdad? To eat. ¿Comer?
Ah, lleva el tú, ajá.
To eat. I like to eat in my bed.
Ah, lleva el tú.
Sí.
Ajá.
Comer. Okay. El
verbo en infinitivo. Or, for example, you can say, I like to watch TV in my bed.
Teacher. Uh-huh. Y digamos que yo le contesto eso. I like to read in my bed.
Yes, I like to read a book in my bed. Yes.
Y ya no se le agrega el in my bed time to relax. Ya no va lo otro.
Podría
no.
decir.
Podría.
La otra opción es responder. At bedtime, I like to read a book.
Ah.
Or at bedtime, I like to eat. Or at bedtime, I like to watch TV. Si lo quiere contestar así. And at bedtime, I like to watch, let's see, Facebook to relax. I don't know. Entonces, puede usar cualquiera de las dos formas. Uh-huh. Puede responder, at bedtime, I like to do this and this.
Uh-huh. But, digamos, at bedtime, I like to Facebook.
To watch Facebook.
To?
Watch. Yes.
Watch better.
Uh-huh. Okay. Very good. Do we have extra questions?
Facebook.
Everything okay?
Sí, it's okay.
Perfect. Yes. See you. See you in a yes. couple of minutes, okay?
Thanks.
You're welcome. Hello.
Hola.
How is it going?
Hello.
Is everything okay here? Are you no. practicing, my dears?
Sí, solo que tenemos una consulta.
Adelante.
Por ejemplo, en what time do you usually get up in the morning? Ha marcado las preposiciones en negro, ¿verdad?
Yes, because you can start your answer in that way. For example, let's see.
Pero para responderle, por ejemplo, si yo le pregunto a ella, un ejemplo, what time do you usually get up in the morning?
Uh-huh. Ella responde.
¿Cómo sería? Correcto. Ajá, o sea, in o at no. wake up.
In the morning, ella respondería, in the morning I get up at 5 o'clock.
Ah, ok.
O puede decir.
O sea, con la misma preposición.
Puede responder así, o puede responder, I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. O sea, siempre la va a usar, ya sea que inicie con la preposición uh-huh. o que la utilice en el medio. Por ejemplo, en la siguiente. At what time do you usually go to work? Usted puede decir, I usually go to work at 6 a.m. in the morning.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But you always use it to give the answer. Usted siempre usa la preposición para responder.
Yes. Y lo mismo que en el 6. Is your birthday in June?
You
no,
say,
my
no.
birthday in, mm-hmm. o sea, October.
Yeah, you say, no, my birthday is not in June. My birthday is in October.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
Siempre usando la misma preposición.
Yes, yes. Excellent.
Okay.
Do we have more questions?
No, gracias.
Perfect. See you. Okay.
No, 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 no.
Hello, chicos. ¿Qué me les pasó? ¿Me lo sacó la aplicación o ustedes terminaron?
No, terminamos.
Okay, perfect. I'll call you back. I will come back in a minute. I will just check the last group. Solo voy a supervisar al último grupo y regreso en un minuto, okay?
Okay.
Perfect. See you. you.
Perfecto.
En la siesta. Bedtime, o tiempo de dormir. Ajá. Sí. Ajá. ¿Y el 8?
Lucho es.
My dears, I'll call you back in a minute.
Can you remember?
Okay, people is coming back from the practice. I hope that you have been able to answer the questions. So let me share the screen of the practice. Okay, perfect. So who would like to start? Would you like to start, Mr. Martinez? Víctor and Mario, solo le voy a cambiar el nombre al señor Martínez. Vamos a rename. Solo si me regala su nombre de nuevo, señor Martínez.
José Rigoberto Martínez.
José Rigoberto, ya me lo voy a aprender del todo. José Rigoberto Martínez. Okay. Vamos a poner completo su nombre. Ok. Would you like to start? ¿Le gustaría comenzar a ustedes? La dinámica es hacerle una pregunta al compañero. El compañero responde. Y quien respondió, lanza la pregunta a su último compañero, de manera que cerramos el círculo de ese grupo, ¿sí? I don't know if I'm explaining well. Okay, you can start. Time is yours. El tiempo es de ustedes.
Comienzo.
Yes, please.
What time do you usually get in the morning?
Okay.
Number two.
Okay, for whom?
At what time?
Perdón, don Roberto, ¿para quién era la pregunta? Para que responda.
Para Mario.
Okay, Mario. Mario, the question is.
Okay, I usually get up at 4 a.m.
Okay, very good. Now, Mario, it's your turn to ask. Ahora es su turno de preguntar, Mario. Pregúntale usted a su compañero y ahí cerramos el círculo.
Okay. At what time do you usually go to work or school, Mr. Rigoberto?
Oh. I usually go. I go.
Mm-hmm.
Why day? Afternoon.
Okay, ¿cuál era la pregunta? Perdón, what time do you?
At what time do you usually go to work
it's time.
Or school?
Okay, ¿a qué hora se va a trabajar? What time do you usually go to work?
At work.
Yes.
Six
in the morning, okay? So Don Roberto says, I go to work at, usando la preposición, at 6 in the morning. Very good, excellent. Does someone else in this group? There is someone else in this group? ¿Había alguien más en este grupo? ¿O solo usted? Okay, yes. Okay, now, tal vez si Don Rigoberto...
También Víctor estaba.
Ah, ok. Entonces,
éramos cuatro.
Víctor le pregunta a usted y usted le pregunta a Víctor. Y ahí cerramos, porque ya Don Rigoberto participó con Mario, ¿verdad?
Ok.
Ok, you can start.
What do you usually do on week afternoon?
I usually work.
Afternoon.
In afternoon.
Okay, I usually work, right? You say I usually work on weekdays afternoon. Sí,
para weekday afternoons.
Yes, para enfatizar la preposición. Okay, now you ask her. Ahora pregúntale usted a ella.
Do you always eat lunch at noon?
I always at
eat.
Eat.
At
20. At 20, eat pupusa.
Okay, ¿a qué horas? At what time? ¿A qué horas?
20.
El almuerzo, at 12.
Uh-huh.
12, and eat pupusas. Very good. Excellent. Thank you, team. Okay, José Edgardo Pérez, team, el equipo de Don José.
Yes, yes, teacher.
Okay, who was your team? ¿Quién era su equipo? Vamos a ver.
Permítame que me salí aquí. Permítame. Vamos a volver.
A ver, chicos, ¿quién estaba en el equipo con Don José?
Hola, Martínez.
Ismael Duarte, yo.
Ismael Duarte.
Ok. Sí. You can ask to Ismael. Usted le puede preguntar a Ismael, luego Ismael responde y le pregunta a la otra persona que estaba en el equipo. Ok. And then you close the circle.
Ok.
Number 6, compañerito Edgardo.
Do you ever take a nap in the afternoon? Why? Why not? Do you ever take in the afternoon?
No, my, ¿cómo sería? No, my birthday.
No,
is
if you take a nap, si toma una siesta a la hora del almuerzo, al mediodía, at noon. Le preguntó la number 5.
No fue las 6 la que me preguntó.
No, he asked number 5.
Number 5, okay.
You can say no, because I have to work. Yes.
No, what sería? No, I don't take, sería.
I don't take a nap in the afternoon.
Take a nap in the afternoon.
Because I have to work, maybe.
Why? Because I work.
Okay, very good, excellent. Now you ask to your classmates. Ahora pregúntale usted a alguien más de sus compañeros que estaba en el equipo.
Okay, Paola.
Okay, Paola.
Is your birthday in June? If no, when is your birthday, Paola?
My birthday is in December.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Do we have someone else or only you three?
Only three.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. Let's see. El equipo de Rosenberg. Okay. Rosenberg team.
Hi.
Hi.
Me tocó con Ingrid y con Fernando.
Okay, now you can start asking to Ingrid or Fernando, as you want, como usted considere.
Okay.
¿Con quién?
¿Con Ingrid, quién empieza? No sé si que lo van a preguntar. Oh, ¿aló?
Hola.
Hola.
Le pregunto, teacher, yo primero.
Okay.
O ellos.
Ok, Ingrid, you can start. Que comience entonces. Ladies first. Las chicas primero entonces.
Question 7.
Ok.
Rosenberg, what do you like to do relax at bedtime?
I like to read a book in my bed.
Or at bedtime, ¿verdad? Podría ser también la otra opción.
Ok.
Yes, now you ask. Now you ask to ¿quién era el compañero José,
question.
¿Verdad? Tu José. Ask a question to José. O al
yo compañero se la hago que faltaba. No, Fernando. Fernando.
Ah, Fernando. Okay, perfecto.
Fernando, what do you like to do to relax at bedtime?
I like to drink coffee.
I like to what?
To drink coffee.
Ah, okay. I like to drink coffee. Oh my God. To relax at bedtime. Okay, sorry. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Fernando. Great. Okay, let's see. Vamos a avanzar, chicos, con otro grupo. El grupo de Kenny Flores.
Yes, con Astrid y con Lisbeth.
Okay, please, go ahead. Adelante, chicas.
Astrid, I can't do remember. What do Thursday afternoon?
I was to working on Tuesday afternoon.
Okay. Where is? ¿A dónde estamos? What number is that one? Ah, yes. No. On Tuesday afternoon. Yes. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Next question.
Ahora usted,
¿quién respondió? Le pregunta a la siguiente persona.
Cierto.
Ajá.
Ah,
es cierto.
Yo. Do you ever go skiing in winter?
Si alguna vez va a esquiar en el invierno. Do you ever go skiing in winter? You say yes or no?
No, I don't.
You can say no, I don't.
Because we don't have winter in El Salvador.
Okay, we don't have snow. We don't have snow. Yes, that's right. We don't have snow. Yes.
We don't have snow.
Okay, do we have someone else in the team? ¿Teníamos a alguien más en el equipo, chicas?
Sí. No, Lisbeth.
Okay.
Okay. ¿Lo pregunto?
Sí, por favor. Yes, yes, please. Pregunte.
Okay. Okay, Kenny.
Kenny,
what time do you usually go to sleep at night? What time do you usually go to sleep at night, Kenny?
¿Tiempo es que ocupo para dormir? ¿Algo así es la pregunta?
What time? ¿A qué hora usualmente?
¿A qué hora se va usualmente? ¿Se va a dormir?
At
11.
You can say I usually go to sleep 11? At 10 o'clock.
11
o'clock. Okay.
11 o'clock.
11 o'clock. Very good. Excellent. Thank you. Did you finish, my dears? ¿Terminamos, mis estimadas? ¿O faltaba alguien del equipo?
No.
No, ¿verdad? Ok. Thank you. Ana Victoria's teams, el equipo de Ana Victoria.
Hola, estábamos Raquel, Fernando y yo, pero creo que Fernando estaba conectado con el otro aparato que no escucha, así que solo vamos a hacer Raquel y yo.
Ok, perfect. It's ok. Don't worry. Thank you. Ok. Bueno,
te pregunto primero, Raquel.
Yo te pregunto.
Dale, yo te pregunto primero. Is your birthday in June? If not, when is your birthday?
Number six. I'm not. Yes. Number six is... No, I'm not.
No,
my birthday is...
No, I don't. No, I don't. Ajá, o you can say, is your birthday... Como la pregunta era, is your birthday in June? Sería, no, it isn't. Porque es sobre el cumpleaños, ¿verdad? No, it isn't.
Okay. No, it isn't.
It is.
And it is.
Uh-huh. On.
In the March.
On. Ah, okay. In this case, in March. Yes. Excellent. Now you ask Victoria. Ahora usted pregúntale a Victoria.
Which time? Number one. Victoria, number one. Question. One. What time do you usually get up in the morning?
I usually get up 5 o'clock in the morning.
Okay, thank you, ladies. Thank you very much. Do we have a missing group? Creo que el grupo de Silvita, no sé si estoy mal.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, please, go ahead.
What, Cindy y Emmanuel. Well, what time do you usually get in the morning?
I usually get in the morning at 6 o'clock.
Get up. Esas dos palabritas van juntas, Cindy. Get up. Es un verbo compound. Two words. Get up. Okay?
I usually get up at 6 o'clock.
in the morning. Okay, very good. Excellent. Now you ask someone else. Ahora usted pregunte, Cindy. Now you ask.
Emmanuel. Emmanuel.
Are you here, Emmanuel?
Okay. Hello. At what time do you usually go to work?
¿Cuál es?
At two.
Number two.
Number two. Excuse me. Number two. Es la número dos. Perdón, creo que dejé de compartir por error. Aquí va. Ok, there it is. Ahí lo tienen, chicos. No sé si lo tenemos al compañero.
Sí.
At 6 o'clock. Sería, I usually go to work at 6 o'clock. Okay, very good. Excellent. Do we have someone else missing?
Teacher.
Adelante.
No podemos ya solo decir, ejemplo, at 6 o'clock. Tiene que ser toda la oración.
I was practicing all the sentence for you to talk more, but you can just answer that way. Sí, yo lo hice para que ustedes hablaran un poquito más, pero perfectamente ustedes pueden quedarse hasta ahí, pero sí usando la preposition, ¿verdad? Siempre.
Gracias. Thank you.
You're welcome. Do we have someone missing? ¿Tenemos a alguien más pendiente, chicos, de participar? ¿Hay algún grupo que se me haya quedado? Me disculpo si ya me perdí un poquito con todos. Ok.
Angelito y yo.
Ok, adelante, please. Sí, sabía que se me quedaba alguien. Ok, please, go ahead, adelante. You decide the question.
Ok, Angelito. Hola.
Adelante.
El número. Okay, Angelito. El 1.
El 1, vaya.
Sí.
What?
Ask me a question.
What time do you usually get up to the morning? In the morning.
Okay. I usually get up in the morning at the 6 o'clock.
At 6 o'clock, okay, perfect.
At 6 o'clock, okay.
Do we have
Angelito? At what time do you usually go to work or school?
School. You
at
what do you usually do?
You can say
do weekend afternoon.
Okay, you can,
I usually
go to work at, y la hora a la que usted se va, don Manuelito.
What do you usually
go to work at?
Weekend afternoon.
Okay, in the afternoon. Okay, very good. Excellent. Okay, my dears, because of the time, I need to take your attendance. Vamos a tomar asistencia ahorita. Ana Astrid María Cortés de Rivera.
Here, teacher.
Okay, Ana Lisbeth Alvarado Hueso. Ana Lisbeth.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Ana Victoria Avilés.
I'm here.
Okay, Ángel Humberto Cabrera, don Angelito, acabamos de estar hablando con él.
Hello, sí.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Hello. Cindy Arely Aldana Cerón.
I'm here.
Okay, Ingrid Noemí Recinos.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, José Edgardo Pérez Rodríguez. José Edgardo.
Present, teacher.
Okay, present. José Manuel Bautista.
Present.
Okay, José Ismael Duarte Miranda.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. José, José Rigoberto Martínez.
Okay.
Carla Paola Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Carlita Paola.
I'm here.
Okay. Okay. Kenny Yamilet Flores. Ahí le escuché a Kenny. Sí. Mario Alberto Escobar Polanco.
I'm here.
Okay. Raquel Vanessa García. Raquel Vanessa. No oigo a Raquel Vanessa. Okay. Ahí está.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Rocío Marisol Flores.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Rosenberg Armando.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. Samuel Jonathan. Anaya.
I'm here, teacher.
Silvia Evelyn García.
Present, I have teacher.
Okay, Víctor Arturo Vázquez.
I'm here.
Y tenemos con nosotros a Walter Manuel Vindel.
Yes, I'm here, teacher.
Okay, thank you. William Fernando Moreno.
Thank you.
Okay, excellent. Thank you very much, my dears, for answering to my request of saying you're here. I'm going to stop sharing and I will take the last picture of the night. Voy a dejar de compartir un minutito para que me regalen sus cámaras abiertas y retomar la última captura de pantalla de la noche, ¿verdad? I congratulate you because you were able to speak. Los felicito porque pudimos hablar. I will upload the material. Voy a enviarles el material, chicos, para que ustedes lo... Perdón, chicos, se me cayó un ratito el internet. Les voy a tomar ahorita su captura de pantalla y les decía que les voy a mandar el material, ¿verdad? Lo voy a subir al Drive para que ustedes puedan bajar, ¿verdad? Y poder continuar haciendo ejercicios que están ahí siempre de prepositions of time and place. Ok, thank you for coming and see you tomorrow, ¿ok?
Thank you very much.
Bye. Take care.
Good night.
Good night. Good night. Good night.